We'll take a look at the time.c code here in the notepad, and notice we included standard I.O. and time.h. Now here's our time value, which is a type time t, like we talked about before, which is really probably an unsigned long. Here's our tm struct, and we're going to create a pointer to it, star tp, so that's a time pointer, and just a buffer to be able to put some things in a few seconds, just a simple 100 byte character buffer. Here we pick up the current time, what it is right now. We don't have to pass anything into time, but it will return one of these time values back to us. Then we use that to populate our structure. So there we have the time value, and I will print out for you and show you what that is in a long int so that you can see the value that the computer is working with. Then we make a call called local time, and that is defined in the time.h header. And local time is past the address of the time value. So it can go to that address, pick up that number that we got from the time call, and put that into the time pointer. That's that structure. So this structure will be populated with hours, minutes, seconds, all of those things that we saw in that previous screen. And you get to them by using the structure indirection, the dash, and then the greater than that we saw earlier when we talked about pointers and structures. So we use a time pointer and the arrow, dash greater than, and then the TM hour, TM minute, TM second, and so on, which is going to be in these integers, these decimal values for hours, minutes, and seconds. So we'll print that out, and then I'll show you another call defined in time.h called ASCII time, ASC time, and that is a string, and I just say that ASCII time equals this string, and then here is the actual call that we're going to use down here. So we call the ASCII time and pass it the TP, which is the time structure pointer. So the ASCII time can rearrange those things and give us a common look, hours, minutes, seconds, and date, and so on. We also are able to do our own formatting of that structure. There's a nice function called strftime, and str formatted time, string formatted time, will format kind of like printf with a percent replacement characters. It will format the information out of the time structure pointer into the buffer that we provided. So that's why I gave it a 100 character buffer. This number says don't give me any more than 99 characters because I don't want it to run off the end of the buffer. And then here are the things that I'm going to put in there. Now these have values that you can find in the time.h, but it's basically the month, the year, the years over here, and day, and so on at, and then this is the time down here. Percent I is 12-hour time, and then there's others for 24-hour time, and so on. And we pass it the TP, and that's that structure that was populated by the local time call. And then I just printf out the buffer to show you what this particular format that I put together looks like. So let's go over and run our program. There's the time value right now when I ran this program, and that converts out into the structure as hours, minutes, and seconds. That's what's in the structure. And then ASCII time call, this is the standard call that it uses, and it uses the abbreviations, SAT, MAR, 24, and so on. Then this is my formatted string that I used, which I decided to use the full spelled out names for the day and the month and so on at a particular time. And then the PM comes from this little percent P right here, the AM PM. And that's the end of that program. So time.c, there's quite a few things that you can do in there, and it's can be interesting with the different combinations and permutations, because there's a lot of different little characters that can be used in the string formatted time. But it all really comes back to the time struct that we used, that we looked at earlier. This one here. These are the values, the TM sec, TM min, TM hour, that are of most interest to you in time.h. So that's the time header of the standard library.